These are exceptional times for the residents of Collingwood, Ontario, and Canada. And we have seen our provincial and federal governments take extraordinary actions to reduce and combat and flatten the curve of the spread of the coronavirus. It is a powerful threat, and it is one that we are taking extremely seriously. We have seen the federal government suspend parliament. We have seen our provincial government suspend parliament. We have seen our provincial government declare a state of emergency. And this morning, we saw and heard as Prime Minister Trudeau unveiled an $82 billion financial aid package to help Canadians through this threat. And we at Collingwood are taking this threat very seriously. And we are asking our residents to practice safe social distancing, to limit your social contact as much as possible, to wash your hands for a period of at least 20 seconds, to use hand sanitizer, and to wipe down any handheld phones and devices, and do everything you can to protect yourself from the spread of this virus. We know that things will get worse before they get better, and we are doing everything we can at Town Hall to take steps to limit the spread of the disease in our community. We have closed our municipal facilities, and that includes the Eddie Bush Memorial Arena, the Central Park Arena, the Centennial Pool, the library, Simcoe Street Theater, and other facilities to make sure that we are doing our part to make sure this disease does not spread as much as possible. And we are asking our residents, as a community that has a proud heritage and has been ranked 22nd best place to live in Canada, and is now partnering with the UN Habitat on sustainable goal number 11, which is to build safe, inclusive, and resilient communities. We are asking our residents to take precautions to protect themselves, to reach out to your neighbors, especially those who are prone to this illness. So they may be elderly over the age of 70, they may have compromised immune systems, and they may have chronic health issues. And we would ask all our residents to reach out to those people in particular and make sure that we're doing everything possible to keep them secluded and isolated. So by getting them groceries, by getting them necessities, and making sure that they are healthy. We are asking people to shop responsibly. We do not need resources or supplies beyond a 2-week supply. And you do not need to buy water or stockpile water. All of Collingwood's essential services, including fire service, water and wastewater, and ongoing snow removal, should that be necessary. And as well, Town Hall is open to calls and emails looking for advice and information. We are not open physically, so you cannot get into Town Hall. All of these precautions are being done to protect our residents, but we are making sure that you have the best information available to you as this situation evolves, which is very quickly. We know that the Simcoe-Muskoka District Health Unit has been very active. We know that Collingwood General and Marine Hospital has set up an assessment center in their parking lot in a tent. If you are not feeling well, please do not go directly to the hospital. Please contact either the Simcoe-Muskoka District Health Unit or the CGMH, or go to the assessment center, but do not go directly into the hospital. Everybody is working extremely hard to combat this virus and to reduce the risk and to flatten the curve so that our health care facilities and supplies are sufficient. And we at Town Hall are working very hard to make sure that the residents of Collingwood have the best information and and that you are top of mind. The health and well-being of our residents is top of mind for this council. We have suspended our weekly meetings and meetings of local boards and committees pending further notice. Our next scheduled council meeting is April 20th. However, that does not mean that council is not working. All 9 members of our council are working extremely hard from their homes and on a daily basis to make sure they are serving the interests of our residents, and our staff are here, and we are making sure that we are taking precautions to isolate or separate senior staff so that we are protecting our senior staff from contracting the virus in-house. And all of these measures are being done to make sure that our community is in the best shape moving forward to respond to the risks as things unfold. And we will be providing daily updates to the public And we ask for your cooperation and understanding, and I encourage everybody, please get out and make sure that those neighbors or people that you know of who are at risk are getting proper attention so that their needs are kept, are being met as well. Thank you very much, everyone, and take care of yourself.